hi at the end.
Hey.
Hello, everyone. Hi.
Here we are, back again.
How exciting.
Wait a minute, I've got a noise in my phone.
Oh, I think that might be me. Is that me?
I'm making a funny noise.
I'm not moving. I'm not breathing.
Okay.
Well, it's good to breathe, but you know.
I won't come and adjust it for you. hi, everybody. So
hello, everyone.
Hello.
That's always me.
See, I don't need a microphone.
No, you can just hear it's loud enough, aren't you?
Your nice bellowing voice coming out.
Holler out to everybody. Hi, everybody.
Nice to see
you. This is the
Alan's
team back again. For the second time today, we were live this morning.
We were.
So we're very excited to be back. This is our normal live show kind of time at 3 o'clock. See, we all like to have a little fiddle with the knobs.
There we go.
Just record.
I wouldn't know what I'm doing.
A mixing device down there.
No one wants to be left out.
Yes.
Just need to calm me down.
That's
you.
Oh.
There.
He gets left out otherwise. Poor thing.
Anyway, so this is our regular, very professional
organ keyboard showcase.
From Alan's Music Centre in Great Yarmouth.
Yes.
And today we have all three of us. We have
Yay.
Marvellous Lucy with me, and my colleague Tom, and my name's Trevor. And we work at Alan's Music Centre in Great Yarmouth. And every Tuesday at 3 o'clock, we like to showcase the instruments that we have in our show.
What we've got.
Because today is Maestro Day.
It
is. Exciting.
We thought that we would have a verse. No.
No, no.
We thought we would showcase the beautiful Maestro. Okay. Lucy just
Look at this. This is amazing.
There.
It's beautiful.
We want the sound of the Sail of the Century music going on.
That's your bit, isn't it? amazing.
It's been very good today. And we've had a fantastic response to our videos. And people seem to be enjoying them. The 10 reasons for owning... Maestro.
Maestro.
We apologise for them being quite long, but we do have a lot to say. You should probably notice from all these videos, we do like the sound of our own voices. And hope you've enjoyed the Patreon one. We actually we say that was quite long, about an hour and a half. So that's quite a video that one.
Sign up now.
Indeed, yes. Be tempted to sign up. Or if you did purchase a brand new Ringway Maestro, you wouldn't need to sign up for the first month because your
free
tablet would have a month's access free of charge that Lucy has here to show off.
There we go. Okay. I have to open it. You just can't leave it at the cover. Look at this. This is amazing. I love it.
This is can we turn it on?
It would help.
It's the thing with these tablets. They always put the buttons
There's
in the
button
most obscure
the
places.
I've got it. There it is. There it is. Look at that.
There you go. Can you crack the code for the screen?
I know what it is. You told me earlier. Hang on a second.
Very exciting.
Have I got
there
it right?
Go. And there we go. We're
there we
and
go. Look
at that. Straight up onto our Patreon page so you can watch what we've got.
It is such a cool one. And I love the cover on the front. It's
indeed,
amazing.
Yes.
Look at that. I just got to show you one
stylish.
More time.
Yeah.
It's so good.
And you can keep music in there and your pens and your memory sticks and everything. It's very versatile.
Put your £50 notes in the back, maybe.
Whoa, if you've got any left. So let's say hello to everybody on the chat. We can say hi to Ernie from Cedar Falls. He was first up. Peter Steen is back again.
Hey.
We've seen a couple of videos now, so he's ready to go live.
Lovely.
And well done, Peter, for watching both videos.
Yes,
it's impressive.
Hope you didn't do the drinking game with the,
no.
the first video. Wayne, that's good afternoon, Trevor and Tom. Looking forward to a great musical day. Yeah, I think it's been great fun. We've had some wonderful feedback as well, which is lovely. James Parrott. Says, fantastic, I've learnt a lot, not on my Maestro, but on his Ringway A2000. That's
nice.
The thing, actually. If you're lucky enough to own an A2000, very similar operating system. So, you can learn a lot from there. Stephen Edinburgh says, good afternoon. Nice to catch a showcase for the first time. Yeah, well done. Thank you.
Aww.
Thanks for joining us. Philip Russell, good afternoon from Hemel Hempstead.
Hi, Philip.
He is taking a break from teaching science and maths to listen to some great playing and
Half
demos from the Showcase duo. It's the Showcase trio today. I go caravanning. Says, good afternoon from Mick in Cambridge.
Hello,
hi, Mick.
Oh, hi, Mick.
Are you in a caravan now? That's the question.
That is the question.
Very brave going caravanning in the winter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Les Stevenson says, hello, Trevor and Tom, watching from Toronto, Ontario, and Canada.
Oh, Canada, how nice is that?
Graham Williams, good afternoon, everybody. Pannington has enjoyed a marmalade mince pie.
Hey.
There we go. Can't go wrong with a bit of marmalade.
Yes.
I made some nice banana bread this weekend.
Did you?
Yeah.
You're ditto. I made some the week before. The old Mary Berry recipe. chocolate is yum.
Do you know, I have this thing about wasting food.
You do?
So if we have bananas that are going
you've
off,
got to put them.
You've got to make your banana
it's incredibly
bread.
Incredibly easy to make.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they're perfect really nice. For banana bread when they're that mushy.
As squidgy and black as they can come. Yeah. And they're delicious. I do like a nice bit of banana bread.
Do you ever have chocolate chips?
No, ours is very healthy. We don't add anything to it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So no sugar or butter.
Not a bit of Malibu in there.
General ingredients.
But chocolate chips would be nice, wouldn't they?
Would they? Be nice, yeah.
So you have to put a little bit of flour on them so they don't sink to the bottom and all
right.
That. Yeah. Yeah, we know all
put some Malibu
tips.
In it. That'll tip it up a bit.
Of Ballymoo.
Yeah, a bit of Ballymoo.
Yeah, the kids will love that.
Yeah, I bet they would. Can I have some more of that?
Very good.
There you go. Come to Alan's Music for your cooking tips.
There you go. Tip of the week.
Willis Stevenson says hi everybody.
Hi.
Wayne Cress says hello Lucy, Trevor and Tom. This has become my favourite of Tuesdays.
That's nice.
Peter Steen, we should club together to buy Trevor some brighter ties. He's got his funeral attire on again. I like this tie. It's very subtle. Steve Bailey, hi folks. It is really great to see you on the story of the weekend.
Hi Steve.
It was nice to see you, Steve. Steve did this wonderful thing where we keep asking people, come down and see us.
Yeah.
Come see us in the store. We love it when people visit.
Yeah.
It's great.
Nice.
David, hello again, Trevor, Tom and Lucy. Enjoying the maestro and the maestro. Yes.
The maestro's on a maestro. David.
On one maestro to another.
Les Stevenson does a special hello just for Lucy.
Nice of you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Steve Holman, good afternoon to everyone. Hi Steve. John Steve. Carter. Tom's had a haircut.
Hi, John.
Yeah, he has a haircut, but not a shave.
No.
He
grew during the day.
It's a new trend, isn't it?
A la Kurt Russell.
Well, if it carries on like that, you're going to look like a caveman by the end of the week.
I don't know. No, I can't shave every day. I have to shave every few days, so I get rash.
Oh, okay.
That's your excuse.
As well, yeah,
exactly. It's all the trend, you know.
Where'd you get the rash? In your wallet?
That's right, yes.
I go caravanning, says no, but he's learning lots about his maestro. Oh,
hey,
that's good.
Well
we
done.
Yeah.
Cool.
Graham Williams, Paddington would like some banana bread. Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, I suppose you could spread some marmalade on there.
Send you some over.
And Douglas Watts says, nice to see the team all together, sitting back, waiting for the music.
Yeah,
well, we opened up with a bit of Bond movie.
We did. You only live twice.
You only live twice.
I'm sorry, I should say. You only live twice, so buy a maestro.
Yes, make the most of it while you have the chance. Maybe we should have one of those, like, you know, where you like to do these silly videos. Yeah. We should have Q.
Yes.
Introducing Bond to his new maestro. It's got a gadget for every eventuality.
It sounds good on James Bond.
You'll find your USB socket. Whatever you do, don't plug anything into it. Well,
yes.
Why not?
This button here is the ejector seat.
You're joking. I never joke about my work. Brilliant.
Oh, yes. There's no ejector seat, though, I'm afraid.
No,
sorry about that.
It's very nice, isn't it? It's very
nice. It's lovely.
So it's a very big seat.
It's very comfy. It's very comfy.
Excellent.
Do you know, they say that Germans don't have a sense of humour. It's rumoured, anyway.
Okay.
But in my car, it has a BMW voice assistant.
Okay.
So you can say, hey, BMW.
It talks to you.
And ask it to open the window. It's like, well,
right.
I'm next to it. I don't really need it. Anyway, you can ask it to fire the ejector seat.
Hey, really? Now wouldn't that be so cool?
And it actually responds. It goes, firing ejector seat in 10, 9, 8,
and
it
7.
Does the whole countdown to 1 and goes, only joking.
Yeah.
Which was great fun with the first time Isaac sat in this car and he really did.
No, no, it's getting down to 1.
Oh, John Carter.
Oh, hi, John Carter. Trevor would be Q, Lucy, Money, Penny. And Tom Blofeld.
Oh, there you are, look.
Okay, I suppose I could play the villain.
Tom will get your pussy to stroke, isn't it?
Yes.
Miss Money Penny as well, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, I noticed that none of us gets to be Bond.
No.
I wouldn't be Bond. It'd be a bit worrying if I was.
Yeah, we're all peripheral characters. Yes.
Oh, well. Maybe that's Tam, because he's driving the van. So
Actually, Trevor is Blofeld. It's the hair or lack of. Oh,
thank you. I'm redeemed.
You could be James Bond, because your suit you've got on. So that's a very James Bond suit, really,
actually,
isn't it? You know, black with the black tie.
Anyway,
hello everybody.
See where that conversation went. We're talking about James Bond.
For anybody that's new to our channel, welcome. We do play some organs and talk about organs eventually.
We will in a minute.
After we've done the cooking update and
the James Bond talk.
So do we have a second song? Do you have another song?
I have. Yeah. So I'm going to put James Bond away. That was on a Latin style. That was really nice.
Lovely, yeah.
Good old rumba. Rumba. And then I've got Matt the Knife. Hey. We're going to go a bit Frank Sinatra now. I can't even say it. Frank Sinatra. Right, let's have a little look here. So this is one I prepared earlier. Right, and then I like this introduction. This is quite, I like this one. So have a, right, let's put on the. Yeah. Hey. Oh, one at the end. There we go. I love that style. That's called the count. And then I like the introduction. Yes. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4. It's really cool.
And that's the nice thing about the Larry's. We've got the noisy microphone again, haven't we?
Have you?
Is it mine or is it yours? I think it's me.
Yeah, I think.
Not hear anything there. Oh, is it you? You're making all that noise.
Oh dear, all this technical stuff. Yes. Sorry about this.
That's a great rhythm, isn't it?
Yes. Oh, it's great. It's great style that, and that's showing some nice sides of the easy play.
Yes.
Style on the Ringway, because one of the things that we incorporated when we designed Ringway was an easy button.
Yes.
And so the easy button works the same way as it does on another make of organ. That was designed for the hobby player.
Beginning with L.
And what the easy button does, it sets everything up for you if you want to play easy play style. So you can play single finger chord. And it does the very important thing where it doesn't matter if you play the chords an octave lower.
Yes,
they will still come out as if you're playing in the middle.
Good,
so you can find a comfortable place to play.
Yeah.
And all those features are done literally by pressing that one button, the easy button.
Yeah. And then you're all set up.
Designed it to work.
And
it absolutely.
Or without the style.
Yeah.
Absolutely, you can play without the style. So if you're watching our 10 reasons to own a Ring Maestro,
that is number.
It was number, I can't remember
six.
Now. Six, was it? Not six?
Six.
Yeah. Easy play.
I did the slides.
Yes. I thought that would have been a good game. I was going to get like just 10 numbers and pull them out and see who can guess which one it was. I remember the last one because that was affordability. That's very important.
Very important.
Yes. Les Stevenson's wonderful selection, Lucy. Make the Knife. Like the voices you selected.
There we go.
Well, we're going to do a bit of musical chairs now.
Oh, yay! Do we win a prize?
So I'll turn your microphone down, Lucy, while you swap over with Tom.
Oh, it's me now.
Indeed, yes.
So sudden.
Tom in the chair.
This is so sudden. Actually, I haven't had a go yet.
Yeah. Actually, no, you haven't sat at the organ today, because I was on there this morning. So, get yourself all settled in.
Bear with,
get yourself set up.
There
we go. And it's very funny when we look at the feed on here, because it is actually delayed. So I can just watch everybody shuffling around.
I think I'm there.
Tom is here.
I think I'm there.
Wanting to stereotype you, Tom.
Really?
But it's always nice when you sit down the organ because you do such a good job playing the organ sound.
Thank you.
And that's the other really big area that we worked hard on when we designed the Maestro.
Absolutely.
Was to improve the orchestral voicing. Are you okay there, Tom?
I'm fine. I'm just getting myself nice and wriggly. That's better.
So should we enjoy some of the organ sounds you're going to choose? Well, because that's the thing.
I was thinking, because I've actually popped in the stick that comes with the organ.
Yay, nice.
Da, 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 da. So, because normally when we do demos, obviously we always like to play the organs as they are. But the one great thing that comes with a Maestro, when you treat yourself to one, is you get the Maestro USB power, which contains a huge range of additional presets. And also, with our special offers of the iPad and everything, you're also going to get the March and Broadway power, which maybe we'll play those a little bit later.
Nice. Brilliant.
But there are some lovely, if I load the right ones in, and at the, literally at the touch of a button, you get a huge range of really nice organ sounds and theatre organ. And we actually have two buttons on the organ panel. We've got an organ button that contains the jazz organs, the organ flute combinations, and we'll hear some of those, the beautiful sample church organ sounds, cathedral organ. But then we've also got a dedicated theatre organ button that has page after page after page after page of not just ready mixed sounds, so almost like if you think of them like little tiny registrations.
All the stuff all blended together for
you.
Yes.
A theatre organ ready meal, if you will.
Right.
tibias, and we've got individual ranks like trumpets, loads of things.
Maybe we should trademark that, a theatre organ ready meal.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Pop your Wurlitzer in the microwave for 3 minutes on a 900 watt.
What sound it would make. It doesn't go ding when it's finished.
Yes. Anyway, something.
So Tom, we will pierce the cling film.
Twice. Stir halfway through.
And enjoy some
noise.
Theatre organ sounds.
Yeah. We'll do some of those, yeah. That's rather nice, yes. Yeah. Rather cute. Yes, lovely, lovely sounds. And of course, we've also got a hall bank actually right inside the factory piece. Can I turn it off, Trevor? Is that all right?
Are you going to restart it?
I think so, yeah, just for fun.
So, what Tom's doing there is that there is a factory setting, there's the factory presets, which are there every time you turn your organ on. So, without having to put a memory stick in, without having to load anything in, you can literally turn your organ on.
Absolutely.
And you're immediately presented with four banks of presets, 16 in each one. And they are very carefully arranged so that bank A is all theatre organ.
Absolutely. And also they're gradiated from the very quiet in number one all the way up to number 16, which is like the full theatre organ.
Full beans. Yeah.
The full beans, as it were, which is really nice.
And then bank B is our electronic organ sounds, which does end up with some classical organ voicing as well.
Absolutely.
So I'll turn it back up for you, Tom.
That would help.
Were you worried then?
I was. I was like, have I plugged the headphones in?
I was wondering, I wonder how long shall I wait before I...
I have no faith. See, the reliability of Ringway, no, it's fine, providing there's no one else in the room.
That's fiddling with the controls. Yeah. Yes.
So that's A1, and then as you go to A2, they sort of they build, and then you get a few novelty. This is one of my favourites. Number 12. It's got the Kinura. And then number 16 is the full McCoy. So the nice thing there is, so you start with number one, and they all gradiate, which is how it would be on most organs. You always start number one very quiet. And then, as Trevor was saying, bank B, carry on, Trevor.
Is our electronic organ voicing. And so again, we spent a lot of time working on getting the lovely, mellow, warm sound that we kind of like in the UK. That's been very popular with the Lowry organs. And I think we did very well with that, even though we just do say so ourselves.
Absolutely. And of course, the great thing is, I mean, that there, for example, that's just one sound, flute 16 and 4.
Yeah.
But then I can put the same sound next door, but put in up an octave. And you get some beautiful sounds, really nicely. It's very easy just to move the things up and down. Really pretty.
Nice.
Mm.
Nice.
Yes.
I like that. Yeah. And I think that it does culminate actually on that particular bank. We squeezed in some church organ. But I mean, they're arranged in groups of four. So the first four are for like slow swing style. The second bank of four, as Tom is demonstrating, is for Latin style.
I like that. Oh, steady on. Really pretty, really nice. And then these are some of my favourites, these lovely church organs.
You always like a bit of church, don't you?
Very regal. Actually, we had a special set included. And rather than sort of putting all the complicated sort of terminology, because people go to try a church and they have diapason and, you know, roflot and all these funny words on the stops. And so we actually labelled them just P for quiet, PP, MF, we put the actual dynamic on. So P is obviously for quiet. And you get that lovely soft sound there, which is really pretty.
And a warm sound as well. A lot of people associate church organs with being kind of big and harsh.
That's right.
But actually, it's a very warm, mellow sound.
Yeah, this is nice. There's a flute celeste down here. It's that lovely glowing effect. And then right up, as again, they gradiate and you can mix them together. And because, of course, we've got the pedal board, although it's not the traditional depth full size one, it's actually a 2-octave pedal board. So you can actually play right up the top and play most repertoire on there. And of course, we've got two console keyboards. Which is absolutely brilliant. And of course, the pedal board, which of course is always a big question for pipe organ players, is it a polyphonic pedal board? And yes, it can be made polyphonic. You can turn the pedal voices and actually play those fifths on the pedals, which of course, cool. A lot of... very impressive. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Lovely.
We missed that in the middle of there. There was the bank from 9 to 12, which was I gave our jazz organ settings. Always like a nice bit of jazz.
A bit of jazz.
Nice.
Yeah, so I do a bit of that.
Got it. Give it a bit of that.
Decide the key I'm playing in. Thank you. Hey, that mistake. Well, I mean, that variation at the end worked out well. Now, of course, what I was doing there, of course, Trevor and Lucy noticed this. We had the jazz hands. I put the D button on, so I could lock in my choice of rhythm and tempo. But then, as I was playing, I was actually changing the swing big band choices on the screen to sort of vary the drummer. Okay. Mm. And of course, with complete confidence that nothing would go wrong.
And you've got the lower keyboard as well.
And in fact, we actually have sounds in the organ section specifically for this, that was actually called lower organ. And of course, any voice can be adapted. So even if you start with, say, jazz organ, now that obviously people go, ugh, that doesn't sound good, because that obviously is set for the upper keyboard. But if I just simply tap a button, and this is the great thing with the creative side of the Maestro, is it's very easy to change sounds.
Oh, which number was that?
Pop it up. Creativity was number 7, I think. So I can now use that organ sound on the low. Hey,
look at that. Yeah.
Made it. Yes. Well, that's my three tunes.
There we go.
Yes, very, very good. Yeah, and of course, well, actually, we might as well carry on with the factory banks while we're here, mightn't we?
So, little recap is A was theatre organ, yes. B was mainly electronic organ, mm-hmm. and a bit of pipe organ at the end. C is our orchestral bank. It's some nice stuff in bank C. Tom getting a bit carried away with his fiddle there. Are you on the fiddle?
I am. And notice, of course, well, that was the split lower keyboard.
Yeah.
Oh, listen to that.
Get a bit of Parisian there.
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it?
Very beautiful.
And we've got guitar waltz, we've got a little easy jazz. Yeah, very pretty.
Yeah.
Nice sound.
Nice and laid back.
Yes. And this is one of my favourites. This has got the lovely voices. We've got some beautiful vocal sounds. And we'll just sing out, love it. That builds.
You hear the soprano in there.
And of course, the melody on chord harmony working, so it's great, it's lovely nice. Settings.
We did a bit of James Last in there as well.
There is a bit of James Last.
Is that 11 and 12?
Probably. No, that's the pan pot.
That'd be 9 and 10.
Nine and 10. Yep, there you got it.
There we go.
Actually, this would be a good point to mention the touchless controller.
Ooh.
Which sounds like a very bad Thomas the Tank Engine episode. So if we
very PC.
It was very PC. Yes. It was a normal day on the island of Sodor. That's it. And what we can do with, we have a wonderful motionless controller, which is brilliant. It's an infrared controller. And we can make it do all sorts of wonderful things simply by waving at it like this. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
See, didn't even touch it. So we've got loads, not just functions, but we've also got sound effects.
Oh, hello.
So I've got that there.
But that's my favourite. I love a bit of wind chimes.
I do like a bit of wind chimes. I do. Now then. Now I can then bend the notes. But I can actually,
it detects how close your hand is to it.
So it's a much more natural way. And of course you can even control, you can adjust how sensitive it is. So it will actually detect a little sooner from where he is. But it is brilliant because sometimes people find, you know, if you're busy, you're playing, you can't take your hand off and do the thing. And yes, you've actually got the second expression pedal, but some folks are not used to using those. And so by using the touchless controller, you can then get effects like this.
Maybe that might be better on the pan pipe.
Actually, I was literally about to go to the pan pipe.
That's better, yeah. I would use it more on sounds like that, yeah.
Saxophones. Bit mountainous there. It's brilliant. It's really absolutely fantastic. And really
what's nice there is you weren't overusing it there.
No, I wasn't actually. No, I thought I was being quite reserved actually. Yeah.
It's like when I have the wind chime on there. It's like every chord finishes with a wind chime.
But of course, people go, okay, so it does some noises. What else does it do? Well, it's not a one-trick pony by any means.
A one-trick pony.
They're all down on the seafront. We can, for example, if we're playing, let's go to Bank D. And
Bank D, for anybody, I just while Tom's getting himself ready. Bank D is where we put all of the easy play variations. So these ones are all set up for automatic bass, automatic playing. I think we put the train actually fairly early on.
I think we did actually.
Yeah. And what's quite good fun with the train is that if you use a fill-in, the fill-in will give you the train whistle.
It does, yes.
Which you are contractually obliged to do the hand signal every time you do it. So you can put your train signal on the touchless controller. When you're doing a woo-woo, you can actually trigger the woo-woo.
Absolutely.
There you go, Tom found it. There we go.
Okay. Well, we better do the intro.
Tom, let's see you doing the...
Here we go. Ring wave, ring wave. Woo! Yay.
You think with all that train whistle, somebody would get out of the way.
Yeah. Great fun.
As John Carter points out, that was a feature that Roland introduced. They call it D-beam.
Yes.
It's the same idea of having a infrared sensor that can detect movement so that you can... We call it the touchless controller.
We do.
Roland call it the D-beam. They put it on some of the keyboards, and that's something I found really funny. Is you watch people playing keyboards, and they were going like this, hi, but it wasn't. They were bending their notes and stuff.
Absolutely brilliant.
Graham Williams says, don't forget to like and subscribe. Absolutely.
Indeed.
If you're enjoying what we're doing here,
got to do this.
Click on the like button and click on the subscribe to see more stuff.
Yes.
While Tom gets himself a bit carried away.
Absolutely.
Les Stevenson says he likes the hand feature. I'm guessing you're saying the touchless control, yes. Or just Tom's hand. is your hand a feature? nice selection of music, Tom says. Les.
Oh, that's good. Thank you very much.
And Paul Denny says, great to see the Lucy at the Keys bringing back the charm to the show.
Wow,
I'm not offended, Paul.
Charm,
I thought we were charming. Apparently not, no. So, as Tom likes to do, this is a good little segue, seeing as he's made himself onto Bank D. Bank D is our autoplay selection. And so Tom is playing using our Shadows guitar sound. One of the great voicings, actually, on the Ringways are the electric guitars. And they've put a very nice Shadows kind of style, or for playing all that kind of 60s style. So let me stop talking and let you enjoy the dulcet tones of Tom playing the Shadows guitar.
Lovely.
That was just one of the presets. Just number 15 there.
D15, yeah. And if you're wondering how we know all of this, well, fortunately, it's all in the booklet that comes with your Ringway Maestro.
Indeed. Should we play some more of those styles?
Because I think so, yeah.
That's one of the areas, again, with the Maestro that we added lots and lots of new styles.
We did.
And we thought using Bank D would be a great way of showcasing all those new sounds and styles that you can play.
Dixie, I don't know what that
and
does.
We have a bit of Dixieland.
Yeah, I like a bit of Dixieland.
Come in.
Yes, hello. Yeah. So I was more impressed. I was managed to do that while I was playing.
I know you got that. What about that? So each one of the 16 buttons on the D bank is set up for a completely different style of music. So,
very nice.
13 there with Dixieland.
I've got a cha cha here.
Oh, a bit of cha cha cha
cha cha.
That's Strictly Come Dancing.
Olé.
We'll be right back.
Yes, now, a bit wind-chewy.
One of the very nice features that we have on the wind mode, we have mentioned already, is this magical D button.
Yes.
Which means if you do find a style setting in that bank D that you like, and you think, oh, actually, I quite like playing that one, but I want to play with one of the nice organ sounds, then you can use the D button to do that, can't you, Tom?
Did it. Made it. Yes. So I can say, well, if I'm on my cha-cha, which I think I'm on my cha-cha. No, I'm not. I'm on the bossa nova. And for my next trick, back to the cha-cha-cha. So I put the D button. The D button does two very important things. One, it locks the tempo, and secondly, it locks the style. So if I now go across to bank B, I can now enjoy, as Trevor mentioned, those lovely organ sounds.
Oh, that works really nice, isn't it?
And of course, I can play those with the easy button. If I want to play chords and pedals, I just turn the easy button off. But I can still have auto chord on, so I can still play with a bit, because some people like to play traditional chords and pedals, and you can still have that little bit of accompaniment, which is lovely. Or the touch of a button, easy button, and it's all there for you, so you can adjust the bass. Which is lovely.
Yeah,
very pretty.
Oh, I like
very pretty, yeah. Yeah, it's good, that one. Cha cha cha.
I have to remember that one. Well, I'm pressing the wrong button here. There we go.
Fine.
Les Stevenson says, wonderful cha cha selection. Bravo, Tom.
Thank you.
Wes Stewart said, are refreshments served at the party?
Oh,
no, we're too tight for that. Yeah. Actually, no, I've got Ribena here if anybody wants a bit of
Ribena. Very exciting.
It is Ribena, honest.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Mate, it does look a bit like diesel.
It looks like rosé.
I'll have a pint of rosé. when I was at university, there used to be people that drank, they call it diesel.
That's right.
Which was that? Cider and blackcurrant.
Oh, blimey.
Yeah.
Nice. Did you try it?
Pint of diesel.
That's interesting.
And actually, I suppose that was, because that was a very long time ago, we're talking about 30 odd years ago, that would have been a precursor to all of the fruit, fruit flavoured ciders.
Oh, yes.
Because, you know, back then cider was cider.
Yes, right. Made from apples.
And so, you know, the idea of having a blackcurrant flavoured cider was quite a novelty.
But now you
go into the cider selection now and you can have,
Yeah. Wasn't blackcurrant? Blackcurrant was in whiskey, wasn't it? Yeah. You used to put blackcurrant in whiskey.
No.
That's what we're at. No.
No.
No. What am I thinking of?
I have no idea. No.
I remember a guy once. He had something, and he added like a blackcurrant cordial to it.
I think you have. People used to put that in their prosecco and things.
Oh, maybe it was that.
You
have
the kirsch. They call it kirsch.
Kirsch.
Yeah. That they would add to it.
Okay.
And I.
Blackcurrant liqueur.
Yes. My formative years were so wonderful.
That you wouldn't put it in whiskey, though.
Well, I have just loaded in off the included USB stick, the March and Broadway pack.
Ooh.
That's amazing. Well done, that's 50 minutes gone.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, John Carter says a cup of tea and a slice of cake, actually.
that could work well.
And Wes Stewart says, is it vodka in that glass? You've caught me out there, yes. Blackcurrant and vodka.
Yes.
By the pint. Yeah. That's how we get through the
that's
day.
That's how we get
that's
through
That's how
that,
we roll.
Yeah. I like that.
Tom. So could you just talk us a little through what you did there? We kind of glossed over. We said we had a software pack. But a lot of people actually, they hear us talk about software packs and things. They don't actually know what we're talking about, really.
Poise?
I mean, they generally don't know what we're talking about.
No, generally.
Like specifically on this.
Specifically, yes. So to help, obviously, built in, and not just the Maestro, in fact, in any of our Ringway models, so right from the little baby 760 all the way up to our flagship Maestro, they have built in a great set of factory settings to get you going. And these settings were done by myself and Trevor. They're inside our UK versions of these organs, and everything is in there to get you going. But included with every Ringway organ is a registration expansion pack. And this also contains a huge range of additional registrations that you can easily load into the organ. The Maestro comes preloaded with a huge range, as well as this pack as well. And as a little treat, when you treat yourself to one of these lovely Maestro organs, you're also going to get our latest expansion pack, which features a whole range of new registrations, and that one's called March and Broadway, and that is pit orchestras, polkas, and how do you get them into the organ? Well, the pack comes with one of these, a very simple to use USB memory device. And these sticks are fantastic because they can not only hold lots of information, but they work super duper fast, and Ringway being Ringway have got all the buttons down to a few simple presses. So the first thing is we pop it in the little device socket over here, and what the organ does just to start with, it just takes a few seconds to say, hey, okay, hang on, you've just plugged a stick in, let me just scan it, make sure everything on there is okay to use in the organ. Then it says disc is ready. Over here near the USB we have I'm just going to turn my touchless controller off because it keeps doing the filling. Hello. We have load, and it says registration, so I press that. And then on the screen, I get a list of the files that are on the stick. So I've got Hobby 1, Hobby 2. There's easy play versions of those registrations as well, which are set up with automatic pedal and chords. And here we've got March and Broadway. So I've selected that, and all I simply do is I press play, and then I press confirm, and within a split second, done, we've got four new banks, so ever so simple.
Wow.
And the first bank, I believe, is Marches, I think anyway it is.
Is the clue in the title there?
Might be, yeah, yeah. But we've got Marches, we've got Scottish Reels, we've got Polkas. Now what these sticks don't do, they don't add new voices to the organ, they use what's already in there, but we've kind of, it's a bit like one of those fresh things, you know, you get everything all pre-prepared in a box, all you've got to do is open it up. But
would
with
that
the
be like a microwave meal,
yeah,
then?
Absolutely. But with the March and
you're mixing your metaphors.
Absolutely, yeah. But with the March and Broadway pad, we've also got some newly sampled drum pads. And because we have Ringway Maestro a set of four performance pads. Now, into these you can load audio files. As soon as you press the button, it will play the MP3. You can get it to play a MIDI file. In this case, we've got some drum samples. So when you get to the end of a piece, you can push one of the buttons and you get a sample drum sound, which adds a little something extra to the fun, which is really nice. So you actually get included packs. Shall I play a few?
I was going to say.
Shall I?
So, yeah, because we are getting very close to 4 o'clock. We don't want to crash our own video because there was another video queue
there
that
is
become live on our channel, which is a concert performance from our Peterborough showcase.
Yes.
Extravaganza that we hold
indeed
every year.
Yes.
And this was a concert that myself and Tom did on the Ringway Maestro. Mm. And we thought we'd share it with you. So that will premiere nice exactly at 4 o'clock.
Yes.
So if you haven't had enough of us already, Tom, could we do maybe one March on Broadway and then we'll say goodbye?
Then we'll say yeah, cheerio, and we'll do one last number. Absolutely.
Wonderful, yeah.
So this is Bank B. This is the Polkas. And here's a little number, which I hope you'll enjoy after, well, if you don't, tough. and it goes a little bit.
I say that in my concerts. So I'm going to play a little jazz selection, and I hope you enjoy it. And if you don't, we're going to have a little bit of quiet time
instead. Nice, that nice tuba and thing on the bottom there. Then we've got the marches as well. Sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say, before Tom plays his final number with marches, because the marches is always good one to finish. Thank everybody for joining us today.
Yes.
It's been tremendous fun. We've really, really enjoyed it. We will be updating our equipment because we don't normally have three people live.
No.
And so that's why we don't have enough microphones. So we'll buy a new box so we can have three microphones in at the same time.
Absolutely.
Because it's nice actually to have everybody all together, isn't
it? It is.
Maybe we'll get a fourth microphone, we'll get Con up here as well.
Bottle, yes.
And so we will get a new mixer box so we can have three microphones all running at the same
time.
So our Maestro Day hasn't quite completely finished because at 4 o'clock you get to watch the concert. But so far, thank you ever so much for everybody's joined us today.
Thank you
for your emails and your phone calls. It's been a really, really exciting day. As I say, if you're interested in the Maestro, we still have some of the budget left.
We do.
For doing some amazing part exchanges. Mm-hmm. And of course, every new Maestro will come with the tablet as well that will give you instant access
to lots of fun
to six. Three lessons with this lady here, with Lucy.
Okay.
One-to-one on Zoom, already set up for you. I mean, what more could you ask for?
I'll go on.
So if you're watching this on catch-up, don't worry. We don't expect everybody to be watching live because we've all got very busy lives, and it is half-term, so we're probably looking after grandkids and things. So don't worry if you are watching this and catch-up and you think, oh, I've missed my chance. Don't. Give us a call, email. No trouble at all. We're always happy to talk to you. Enjoy the videos. That's the
fun, absolutely
thing. Yeah. So, I think we're all done.
I think so.
Anything more you want to say, Tom?
No.
No.
But thank you for having me.
Yes. We'll have another microphone next week. Definitely.
Absolutely.
And Tom is going to play us out and say, stick around on the channel for the premiere of the concert.
Indeed.
There we go. Have fun. Bye bye. Thanks, everybody.